Okay, so this is a test of the new tripod. I'm gonna be doing an unboxing. We'll just get right into it. This is a package from knifemerchant.com. It's a shop out in San Diego, and they do a great job there. Pretty good selection. Everything they sell, I'd say, would be considered to be good to go. So you can't really go wrong ordering from them. Staff there is super knowledgeable. Give them a call, they'll help you out. So first thing that's in there is actually just a Victorinox paring knife. I bought this for my brother-in-law. I've got several of these, and they're just, you know, inexpensive, handy. They're ground really thin behind the edge, and they're a little bit flexible, really easy to get your thumb out to the end. So those are a good deal. That's just for my brother-in-law there. And here's what that is actually for me. I bought myself a new fillet knife. It's an 8-inch Victorinox fillet knife with the Fibrox handle. Let's take a look at it. This is a flexible standard height profile. Let's get it out of the packaging here. Get that off the tip so you can see. Oh yeah, it's very flexible. What I tend to look for in knives that are flexible like this is when you bend them. So this isn't ideal, I can already tell, for me, but we'll try it out. Is I like the bending to most of it to occur here. It's not god awful. Maybe it's okay. You can actually see a lot of the bending is happening here versus like a uniform curve. So I would prefer that for my flexible knives. You can see the sharpening job doesn't quite make it all the way to the heel there. It's not a huge deal. And I honestly will probably sharpen that back a touch just for myself. These Fibrox knives always come with a slightly rounded tip, so just be aware of that. Super thin behind the edge, 10,000ths, 8,000ths or so. That's how these all come, at 15 degrees per side. How's that edge? Ooh, it feels well apexed. Not a lot of aggression. So will it shave hair? Oh yeah, I'll shave hair. Usually a well-apexed edge will. And then what I also got with this is this beautiful, surprisingly red-colored sheath. So you can bring it out with you when you go fishing. Huh. Am I putting it in backwards, or what's going on here? That's interesting. All folks are seeing it right here. I don't know if this is... There's one of those plastic guards in there that keeps it from getting cut up. I don't know if I'm supposed to put it in backwards. Seems a little goofy. I kind of want to take it out of there. I don't know if I'm a big fan. It does feel like it's glued in. Well, I'll mess around with that, but what's happening is when I try to insert the knife, it's hitting that plastic piece in there, so it'll only go in that far. I mean, it works. Totally holds the knife. Oh, there you go. Got it. So I don't know. I don't think that's supposed to be in there. I think that was just to hold the shape. There you go. I think this is just to keep it from getting crushed. It's garbage. That's better. That's what we're talking about. That way you can bring this out to the lake, keep it in your tackle box, bust it out, get your fillets. So there we go. That's an unboxing of the 8-inch Victorinox flexible fillet knife. I love me some Fibrox knives. They're not the most, oh yeah. This combo, $30. Very affordable, very high performance. I do recommend that you thicken up that 15 degree edge up to 17 to 20, keep it from rolling. But I mean, one of these babies, a quality steel, and you will just be filleting for days. A lot better than your Rapalas and Bubbas and whatever. You know, these guys and the Dexters, that's the way to go. So there's that. Paring knife for $5 for the brother-in-law. Paramilitary 2 in carbon fiber and M4 just for fun. Because why not? All right, you guys have a good time. Bye.